Welcome, Speed Hunters. You're here with Fully Sick, and today we are trying out Construction Simulator 2015. Now, when I last looked at the calendar today, it was 2014, so we've gotten it a little bit early, which is always good. Anybody who's looked at the game or thinking about the game probably recognises the company name, so let's not talk about their past too much. Let's just jump into what they've created. I'm going to take you step by step through the start of this, and then week by week we'll go through and we'll do a level by level sort of a playthrough. So today it's the boring stuff, which is all the options, menus, and we'll do the first basic traditional missions. So let's go here and create a profile. For the name, we're going to put in Fully Sick. And then we'll jump down to the company name, and here we will put Speed Hunter. I don't think we'll be hunting for much speed, but it will do for a company name. And then you got the colours, so company colours. You got your classic white, grey, yellow, horrible green, red, pink, purple, and I'm assuming that's another purple. Would have been good if it was blue, so back to white. So I'm going to go with red because I like red. And then you got your player character. So that's character 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And that's all of the characters. So I'm going to run with character number 5. Confirm that. So you'll see you've got him there. Select that profile, you've got multiplayer, delete profile, and start career. Alright, let's start the career. Let's get on with it. Now this loading bar just tends to take its time from time to time. Now, I did try this yesterday and the traditional mission bugged out, so I'm gonna slow it down a bit and just take it a little bit easy, because I was trying to race through it and get a feel for the controls, because it is actually pretty detailed in the controls. But I'm assuming that comes down to the options, I'm not 100% sure. Alright, we're at the Wolfensheim, I'm not sure if that's pronounced correctly, train station. Alright, now I'll try and do a bit of talking. I'm not going to put on a funny voice and make myself sound like an idiot. That's right, I already sound like an idiot. So, let's get on with it. Ah, there you are. You must be Fully Sick. It's nice to meet you. My name is Peter, but you can call me Pete. Well, I didn't buy him dinner, so I don't know why I'm calling him a love name. Hello, Pete. Thanks for picking me up at the station. I'm very curious to see what is waiting for me here. Well, there's a lot of work waiting for us. I suggest we take our time, and I show you everything before we get to work. That's the fastest way to learn. Okay, I'm looking forward to using the big machines. All in good time. First, we have to drive to the company site. Do you see the little white flatbed truck over there? Why don't you get in it and drive it over to our premises? I'll show you the way on the map in the bottom left-hand corner. Wow, I get to sit behind the steering wheel of a truck already? Yippee! Bit of exaggerated excitement there. Alright, before we start running around, I'll go through all the different options so we get the boring stuff out of the way. Exit button brings up your map, so you can move your map around and... I think that's about as far as I can zoom out. This is your map, and then you've got your legend down here. I have everything selected. Alright, now let's go to the next one, jobs. You got contracts, special jobs, traditionals, and architect missions. Now down here you have active jobs, so we click on active jobs, and this is your current active job. And then you got your different stages. So there's stage 1, which is where we are, and when you click on it, it will have a drop down and it will tell you exactly what you need to do, or, you know, a brief description anyway, and then as you go further along, you got your different stages. Alright, over here you got finances, you got single revenues, single expenses, and then you got motor pool, and it's got all your vehicles. And then you got your trailers, which is There we go. Wasn't working for a second. And then you got your crew. You can hire workers as you go, as you advance further on. And then you got your warehouse. Then over here, you got your profile with your basic statistics. And then you've got your achievements. There's quite a fair few achievements, which is great. Then you've got your XP level. So, you know, I won't sit there and go through all of them. And then you got online, which you can't do as yet until you complete the introductory traditional, which I haven't done because I keep deleting my profiles. Alright, then over here, we'll quickly go through the options. Like I said, I don't want to spend too much time on it because a lot of people find this boring. You got invert, vertical look, so I've got that inactive. Controller sensitivity, medium. I haven't actually touched a lot of these. I just made sure the economy cycle was set to 2 hours and the handling was simulation with the cockpit camera as active. And the controller scheme is just default because it makes it just a little bit easier. I am using keyboard and mouse. I'm not using the gamepad, even though occasionally you might see the gamepad buttons come up, but that's because it's actually connected to the PC. Alright, graphics. Everything is running on full. Because this is for YouTube, I'm running on 1920 by 1080. Now, I did quiz the developer about... For people like me, I have NVIDIA Surround, I have 3 monitors, and it actually does have the option there for the 5760 by 1080, and it does span across all 3 monitors beautifully, just like a European Truck Simulator, so you get that full surround effect, which is actually quite good when you're sitting in some of the machinery, but we'll just leave that there for now. I've got this set to inactive. It's actually running in windowed mode. Graphics are set on the highest setting. That's active. That's on the highest. I do have bloom effect on, but if that starts to get annoying, I will turn that off. Depth of field active. Range of sight very high. Traffic, we're going to put that on very high. The traffic is classic simulator stuff. It is absolutely hopeless drivers. Audio, we've got everything turned up. I haven't heard any music, so... and then the controllers, I'm not even going to go for that. We'll discuss controllers as we'll use machines, because for the life of me, some of these machines have so many controls that you'll be using the mapping constantly. Alright, so let's get underway. I'll quickly show you. If you hit your... Alright, I have to get into the vehicle first. Alright, so if you hit your F1, it's got all the different... As you can see here, it's got all the different controls for the vehicle. There's a lot of controls for just your basic truck. And you actually see it up here. You don't have to use the shortcut keys. You can click on the question mark. Then you can change your camera view by up there, but there is a key for that. Alright, so I'm gonna leave it on that view. And you can jump and set your map markers. So let's get moving. My bird has decided to have a tantrum, so you just have to ignore him. He's smashing around one of his toys in his thing. I do notice that the steering is extremely slow on this truck. Now you need to hold in your left mouse button. Right. Yeah, you gotta hold in your right mouse button to pan around. Oops. Bit of a handbrakey. You'll be seeing that a lot because that is my favourite button. And unlike our European Truck Simulator, this game actually leaves black marks all over the road when you pull on your handbrake. And he runs a bit awkward, but Yeah. All right. So here we are. This is our company site. Small but nice, should be enough for a start. Over there you can see our current fleet. We have two trucks, a small digger and a matching trailer to transport it to the site. I'll show you later how the vehicles work in detail. Great. Alright, I'm very excited. What do we start with? We were commissioned to create a feed for a sister... whatever. We'll need a small excavator for that, as it is not suitable for the road. We will take it to the site on a trailer. You should carefully drive the truck to the trailer, and once you're in the right position, you can couple it. Yeah. Alright then, let's hope that everything works out. I hope we have a good insurance policy. Yes. Yes, I hope for you too. Assuming I said that right. One more tip. The current job status and your task will appear. I pretty much just explained all that, so I'm not going to reread that. Yesterday I drove the excavator there. I drove it off the trailer and I actually drove it to the site. Well, the game didn't like that too much. Alright, outside view here. Once you get close enough, you'll see that there. Alright, now. Quickly hit C. That couples the trailer. Now you have to attract the outrigger. So that's a left shift and Q. Now for the traditional, it's actually showing you the keys. Alright, oops, wrong button. V changes our view. Alright, let's drive to the site. Whoops. Alright, it's not far to go. The actual city itself is relatively small. Alright, here we are. Alright, back, where is the view I'm looking for? Now, for some reason they make you put this in the square, I've got no idea why. Yeah, the steering takes a little bit getting used to it, I don't know why it's so slow. I'm pretty sure when I looked, it turns back faster than it actually turns. See, the turn back is a lot quicker. Anyway, that's you've got to talk to him again. You've got to do this quite a bit. Well, that went very well for now. Of course it did. What did you expect? I'm not a beginner anymore. Fuck off. Now take it slow this time. Fully sick. I will unload the excavator and then show you how to control it properly. I don't need you to show me how to control it. Fucking. What? I wanted to drive it off the track. It ruins all the fun, this bloke. I'll be glad when he's gone. Alright. I'm not going to continuously read this because otherwise I'll drive everybody insane. I can skip through it a bit quicker. And when you get the game yourself, you can read it. Alright, so now comes the fun bit. This took me ages yesterday to work this out. I'm glad I've had a bit of practice. Alright. Just takes a little bit of getting used to. Just for the YouTube videos, I'm actually going to use external view so you can actually see what's going on. I don't have my headset on either, so I can't hear what the sounds are doing. So hopefully the game sounds are recording. Alright, now, I think you might have saw it flash up. You got to hit tab for digger mode. Alright. Now, I gotta try and remember how all this works. There you go. There we go. I don't know how deep he wants this hole, but... Do you know what'd be cool? Why didn't my bucket empty? There we go. If you found some bones while you're digging the hole. It takes a little bit getting used to how the digger works. It took me ages. I kept just lifting the actual excavator off the ground every time I dug a hole. I'd try and dig too deep. But it's not too bad. It's actually better than I have played another style construction simulator, and it is 100 times better than that. Like, just for this I know you're digging holes, but just the way you dig into the ground is actually quite good, the way they've done it. Alright, just to speed things up, we'll say no. Alright, so we're just gonna leave that there. Leave our jobs half finished. I think I've missed what he said. That's out of the way. Come here to me. He's quite bossy and rude. Bit of an asshole. You did great. Looks good. Now we need water pipes. I think a pallet should be enough. Where do I get that? Blah 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 blah. See that was absolute magic. That hole just appeared with the whoops. They make sure the jump's high enough so you can get out of any holes that you dig. Alright, now let's take the truck down the store with the slow steering. I'll have to have a look at the options. I'm hoping it's an option. There we go. Just boogieing. Like I said, things aren't too far in this game. Handbrake it. Oh shit. Of course that had to pop up on the handbrake. Well, let's go jump out and talk to the salesperson. Pretty much just about virtually do everything in this game. Speak to him. You got all your different building materials. I'm after drain pipes, was it? I forgot what he told me to come get. And it's highlighted yellow, so I'm assuming so. Oops. And you have to hire a forklift from him as well. Anybody who follows my Steam profile would have seen the photo, or screenshot I should say there, of me lifting up the truck with the forklift. I'm actually going to use this forklift today. I used the other one yesterday just for the test run. Oops, he jumps like Superman. Very amazing jumper. Let's see if we can recreate that screenshot in real time. Wasn't too hard. You got full tilt on the forks as well. See, you got that way, and then, oh, this one's not gonna let me lift it. Well, that's no fun. Alright, I guess things have changed. You're supposed to put the side of the truck down, but they took a lot of polywaffles. Alright, let's, you meant to put it on the back of the truck. I'm just gonna quickly try and put it on the trailer, because I like to be different. If there's a will, there's a way. So, let's see. There we go. It's not supposed to be there, but whatever. No, what? Attach my cargo. I don't know if I'm going to be able to drive there without that falling off. Yeah, we'll see. Bet you it falls off halfway there. Nope. Ah. God damn it. Now I gotta go back and pick it up. I actually put it on the back of the truck this time, do it properly. Alrighty. Oi. I think that's got it. What? Give me my damn pipes! You meant to put the side of the truck down, but I like to be different. All good. Oops. There we go. And then we'll just park that over here. Always put your forks back on the ground, tilt forwards, jump out. You need to attach the cargo. It will attach in the back of the truck. See, they just put some straps on it. And we're on our way back. And I don't look, I just drive. Like, some people will complain that it's, the world itself is too small, but in a game like this, I prefer it a little bit smaller, because the point of it is it's for the game itself. It's not so much to drive around in a large open world. If you want a large open world, go buy a game that's got a large open world, like Far Cry or fucking, The Crew or something like that. Alright, now I gotta unattach the cargo. Oops, wrong button. There we go, that took it off. Yesterday I drove around in fast circles to actually get it off the back of my truck, but like I said, today I'm gonna try and do this properly, so Alright, I've lost my buttons. Ah, whoops. Alright, let's go up and out. I think I might have to actually speak to the stupid boss first, but yeah, like how he whinges about his poor back. Alright. Let's jump in the excavator. Yep. And you'll see it. It comes up there. Connect. It looks a little bit weird. Alright, let's I just want to get it off the truck, so yeah, yesterday I was lucky enough, when I was driving around in circles, being a clown, it actually rolled off the side of the truck and landed in these two squares. You know, inside the square, inside the four witches' hats. One of these days I'll learn English. Alright, tap, down, alright, now he's gonna explain the next job. Bang, 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 roger. Alright. You can transfer a lot. There is like a fast kind of travel somewhere up in the corner, like here. Here we go. See? And you can just. And he beat me back there even though I fast traveled and everything's perfectly parked. Funny about that. So the traditional really do it the way that they lay out, or otherwise the game tends to not like it. Now we've got to go to the building site. This is where I started screwing around yesterday and not listening to what he was telling me to do. And then again he takes over, he kicks me out the driver's seat, some Grand Theft Auto style, and then he just took the fucking truck and then backs it up to the bin like I'm incompetent. Alright. Extension booms. Used to make these trucks many years ago, so I've actually got quite a good idea how they work. Alright, look at that. Easy. And you don't have to hit any buttons as long as all your booms are fully retracted, you can actually start heading down there. Alright, yesterday I drove there like a crazy man, so let's do the same again. Do it Speed Hunter style. What the? Really? Whoa. The steering is really slow. I've got to really find a way to get on top of that. Because that was part of the problem yesterday. I'd crash into stuff because you'd steer left and right and you wouldn't get any reaction from it. The turn backs, but like I said, it's quicker than the actual turning. Come on, we got damn, I ain't got all day to wait for you. We're on a mission. The mirrors, I don't like the looks of the mirrors. I don't know if I can pan in. Yeah, the mirrors look really pixelated. I hope they fix that. Maybe optimize them a bit. They look pretty horrible. I know you don't in this game. You don't really need to see behind you, but it doesn't look the part. All the roads look freshly paved. Whoop, whoop. And I'm riding on that handbrake again. You can probably hear it. I haven't got my headset on, so I can't hear any of the sounds from the game. Alright. You've got to stop on this weighbridge. Now, this is where I kind of skip. Yep. And then wait for him to say unload the container. So. Alright. Back it up there. Doesn't matter where, as long as it's here. There you go. Space bar. Alright, just to make it a bit quicker, we'll fast travel again. Now that was a lot quicker. Hi Pete, I'm back. A day on the construction site is quite exhausting. Well, he didn't do a whole lot, so I don't know how he's exhausted. Oh man, you have only learned the first machines, but I think you understood the basics of the job. Now you can try to do contracts on your own and start to earn some real money to expand your company. And then while you're sleeping, I'll come into your house and take it from you. Pretty evil, I reckon. Now we can really get going. I'm really looking forward to this. Ah, I don't want to read all this. You know what? Fuck it. If you want to read it, you've got to buy the game. Alright, so that's the first mission. That's the traditional. All done. That shows you your earnings. It shows you how many stages of the job. And that shows you the total experience you earned. And I'm an inexperienced apprentice. Yippee. Alright, stage finish. Earn a bit of cash. And I'm pretty sure if we bring up our jobs, we have contracts. You have a modern single family house with wood panels. Oh, that must be a name. Then you have gardening, and then you have container transport. Transport. Depends where you're from as to how it sounds. So, I'll have a look into it, and next week we'll pick one of these jobs, and we'll bugger off and do them. And I think that's all I can really show you for now. All the other options are pretty basic. Like I said, you can't really... Oh, online, that's it. There we go. Max, and you've... It's local area connection, I'm assuming. So if you want to... If you're an Australian and you want to hook up, like, to an American, or you've got a German friend, I've got a couple of German people on Steam, it may lag. I'm not saying it will, but you might find there is some lag. But I'm assuming this would be a fun multiplayer game. Also, some other things is this game will have Steam Workshop, but at the moment it's been delayed. They did have a few issues, but there is a post in the community hub that you can go check out, and they've got a way that you can go and start modding the vehicles. You just can't put them in the Steam Workshop just yet. I'm not going to get too involved in that because, I just want to keep with the playthrough for now. So, this is Construction Simulator 2015. If you're interested in purchasing it, check it out on Steam. It's just been released. It's early days, but I'd be saying it's not too bad. I'm actually quite enjoying it. Like I said, it's going to get pretty complex, I think, once we start getting to the bigger machines. So for now, this is Speed Hunter, and catch you at the track.